everyone, and welcome to another session of Building Blocks. I'm Judy Brown from the Little Fabric Garden, and today I'm here to show you a fun project. And I think maybe some of you already know how to do this, but for those that don't, it's a fun, easy project that will help you around Christmas time if you're looking for some really cute gifts to give to your children, grandchildren, or just maybe a neighbor. And this is what we're going to work on today. These are pillowcases. And these pillowcases are made in a tube, and you'll see what I'm talking about in a little bit. I really like to make these, and I like if I'm doing a quilt and then I put it on my bed, I have extra pillows, and then I'll make pillowcases to kind of match the new quilt that I put on the bed. And this way, you know, it kind of jazzes it up a little bit, and I don't have to make a sham to put it in. I'm not real good at that. So I'd rather do the pillowcases, and then if I need to use them down the road, I can. So these are three pillowcases that I literally took off the beds at home. And, you know, of course, they look the beds look kind of strange right now because they're missing these pillowcases. So you see what we have here. We have the base, the big base, and then we have, you know, the part up at the top, and then we have a little accent piece. And I'm going to show you how to do that. And once you get going on it, it'll probably take you about, maybe half an hour, 45 minutes to make one of these. So I will show you just in a minute what you need for this project. Okay, so for this project, we need just three little pieces. The first piece is going to be the big piece of the pillowcase, and we need 3/4 of a yard of fabric. All right, the next is going to be the band, and that's part at the top. And we need 9.5 inches. Now I know that there are some patterns that call for different measurements and stuff, but this is what I use and this seems to work for me, and so that's why I'm passing that out on to you. And then this is the accent piece, and the girls usually cut these at either 1 3/4 inches or 2 inches. And I really like the look of the 1 3/4, but the 2-inch one strip is a lot easier to handle. So I cut this at 2 inches. So we have 3/4 of a yard. We have 9.5 inches, which is, you know, roughly 1/4 of a yard. And then we have a 2-inch strip. So this is what we need to get started with our project. And the first thing that we're gonna do is take this big long strip, and I'm gonna fold it in half lengthwise like this. I'm going to take it over to the iron and I am going to press this like this. Okay, before we get started, I want to explain to you about this fabric that's in front of me. I ordered this online for my granddaughter to do some stuff with, and she's a swimmer, and if you look kind of closely, you can see that there are little people swimming in lanes on here. And I had it in my stack, and it was like next to my sewing machine. And when I knew I was going to do this, I looked over and I thought, hey, I might as well just take one of those and I'll get a little heads up on Christmas. And then I realized that the day that I was going to be doing this was her birthday. So it just worked out really well. So, I'll be giving this to Abby when I get finished with it. But anyway, let's get started. Just a little side story. I'm going to move this out of the way for right now, and I am going to take this piece. So how we get started is we are going to take the band piece, and we're going to open it up like this, and we're going to take our little strip that I did go over to the ironing board, and I pressed it, and you can see that I just folded it like that. All right, so here we go. This is going to go right here, and we are going to line this up. The selvage or the raw edges are going to be lined up like this. Just going to lay that in there, and now we're going to take the next piece, the big piece, and we are going to open that up, and we are going to lay this on top of it. We are going to have right sides together. So this is going to go like this, and you can see that there are some of the selvage edge on here. I'm not concerned about that. I'm gonna try and move it over just a tad bit, but when we get all done, you know, because the different fabrics are different widths, you know, some are 43 after you cut off the selvage, some are 42. So what we will do when we get to that section of it, I will trim the pillowcase down to what it needs to be before I start sewing it together. So this is gonna go on top like this. And again, we're gonna try and get those raw edges. And I hope I'm doing a good job because I'm a little shorty here and it's kind of hard to see. Okay, so we've got this laid out here, and of course there's some falling over here, but I'll take care of that. And now what we have to do is to stick a couple of pins in here. I'm not going to put a whole lot of pins in. I'm just going to stabilize it by putting this, and you'll see why in a few minutes. So this is going to go like this. Doing this all the way across. I just don't want this to move on me, so I probably don't even need as many pins in it as I've got, but I really don't want it moving. And you'll see why in a second. Get that big honking pin needle out of there. Slide this down just a little bit. There's not a whole lot left. Now you can see what I was talking about. These are all different widths. So when we get to that point, I will probably just like chop all this off. But right now, we're just going to keep on going. All right. So now I've got it pinned. It's stabilized. That little strip in the middle is basically what I was worried about, and I didn't want that to move anywhere, so that's a good reason. So here we go. Now we're going to take this and we're going to fold it up. We're going to try and roll it up. My fingers will let me. Okay. Now I think I'm just going to lay it here and do it this way. I'm just going to keep rolling it up until I get about halfway. See, I've still got about half of this fabric here, just like that. And then I'm going to take this end and I'm going to bring it up over the top of this roll, like this. And now I'm going to pin it. I'm going to take this pin out and pin it this way. I'm going to bring these down. I'm going to get them all pinned where I originally stuck the pins, and then I'll go stick some in there to make them have more pins in it. And typically I try to make this roll a little smaller, but my fingers just wouldn't do the trick today. So we're going with a fat roll in the middle. Okay, this is going to go like this. And you really want to get these pins close together. So that's why I'm going to stick some in between, because now you've got four different pieces here and you don't want it to slip. So I am just going to keep on going. It's kind of boring to watch somebody pin. I understand that. Those were the original pins. Now I'm going to stick some more in here because you see we have a gap and I'm afraid it'll slide on me when I'm sewing, so I want to make sure it stays in place. I found out about these pillowcases when I went to Florida one year visiting a friend, and the sewing group down there was making them, and one of the ladies gave me the pattern, and it was so much fun to do. I just started making them. And then when I opened the store, there was a thing called a million pillowcase challenge. And so I got involved in that. And my sister-in-law had made a lot of pillowcases for my mom when she was in the nursing home. And it just made her room look so much brighter when she was in the nursing home. And so when we did the pillowcase challenge, I chose to give my pillowcases that we had done to the nursing homes in our area, in Bradford area. And we went to all the nursing homes and we were able to give everybody that was a resident a nice bright pillowcase of some sort. And they were all different things. We did some red, white, and blue for the veterans and that kind of stuff. And it was pretty nice. And a couple of the people that worked at the pavilion said it was really nice when they had them on their beds. It just made their rooms look so much cheerier. So that might be another thing to do again to kind of brighten things up the way things have been lately. So just have to make sure that I don't get that. See that little fat roll starting to inch its way up there. I don't want to sew it or I'll be in big trouble. Okay, just about ready. This one's moving. So now I'm going to take this big tube over to the sewing machine and I am going to sew straight down there and then you'll see what happens next. Alright, so here we are at the sewing machine and this is going to be a quarter of an inch seam allowance here and I am going to sew right along this edge. Now with all these pins, I do not pull my pins out as I go, I just sew over them, whether that's the right thing to do or the wrong thing. That's what I was taught years ago I could do, so that's what I'm doing. And so if the needle from the machine hits the pin, we may hear some loud noises. So here we go. Little roll up is kind of getting in the way and moving some things, so I'm going to try and adjust it just a bit. All right, let's hope we're all right. Here we go. Okay, so we had to do a little adjustment here, and I don't know if it's quite right, but we'll see when I pull this thing out. I think we'll be able to make it work anyway. That's why it's really important when you do all of, you know, when you have all of the layers together and when you bring that up and start pinning, to put a lot of pins. And I thought I had enough, but I probably should have had a few more. So I'm going to sew right off the end and I am going to take this out. And here's my little area that I don't like. It's right in here. So we may have to do some adjustments to that. But I'm going to take it back over here and I'm going to pull the pins out. Get all these pins. All everything is okay, I am going to pull this out of the tube. All right, I'm gonna move these out of the way so I don't knock them all on the floor. And here we go. So I'm just gonna pull this out. Takes a little bit, but it's no big deal. Okay, so now it's out of the tube, and this is what it looks like. So you can see when we do it, it now looks like a pillowcase, you know, like a pillowcase should. So now we just have to do some adjustments to it, and I will, first thing I will do is take it over to the ironing board, and I will press these down and make them flat so both sides are flat. Like this one is kind of bubbled on the back, so I want to make sure. And when I do these, I usually press the back first and get this side nice and flat, and then I come to the front and I do this side. So I'm going to take it over there and get that done, and then I'll be right back. All right, so I've pressed these, and you can see it's kind of laying flat. And now I want to trim off these sides, like I had told you. This side isn't too bad. I'm just going to bring it in as, you know, like where that white is, and I'm just going to cut that. But this other side is, there's more to trim off. So I will get this easy side done first, and then I'll just flip it around and we'll get that done. Okay, so just do this. Okay. All right, and I'm going to be like Eleanor Burns, and I'm going to throw it on the floor, because that's what she used to do. All right, and I'm going to move this way. I'm going to flip it around. All right, and as you see, there's a big piece up here. And sometimes when you order these, you know, some things online, they are a little shorter, but it'll all work out in the end, so it's no big deal. And I'm just going to do that. And, oops, forgot, throw that on the floor. All right, so we got it all trimmed off, and it might not be absolutely perfect, but it's going to work. So now what we're going to do is we are going to put wrong sides together. Now usually we put right sides together, but we are going to do what is called a French seam. Because if we just put the right sides together and we sewed it up, inside the pillowcase would be like a raw edge. And every time you wash the pillowcase, you'd have those strings just falling off, flying all over in there and getting tangled up on stuff. So we're going to do a French seam, and you'll see, if you're not exactly sure what a French seam is, you'll find out in a little bit. So I am not going to pin this. I am going to go as slowly as I can, and I am going to sew along this edge, and then I am going to sew along this edge. All right, and then it definitely will look like a pillowcase, but we won't be done yet. Here we are back over here. I am going to try and keep this as even as I can. And we are going to get started. And I might be upset, you know, at the end when I didn't pin it, but I think I can do this without pinning it. And this is done at 1/4 inch seam allowance, just like we do our quilts and things like that. But we will have to change it when we put in the other seam. And I will show you and tell you why when we get to that point. machine is that every time I stop sewing, the needle goes down and holds everything in place so it doesn't slip out. You can sew straight off the end, but I'm not going to do that. I think what I am going to do is I'm going to go across here because it looks like this bottom isn't quite straight. Well, I think maybe I will go right out, and then I think I'm going to trim it off so it will be straight. So I trimmed off the bottom because it was really off down there, so I took it over to the mat and I cut it so that it would be straighter. So we're going to start again and finish this one side. I'm just sewing over these poor little swimmers' backs as I'm going across here. I go. I'm going to trim it, trim the threads, and get the one up here. All right, so now we have to turn it. So I'm going to bring it back over here and I'm going to turn it. Well, I am also going to trim these edges. Now these aren't really the good scissors to do that with. In fact, I think I'm just going to do this. It'll make it easier. I won't have that bulk there. And so I usually do this with the scissors, but I forgot to bring them over. So I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to turn this inside out. Okay, so I went over, I turned it inside out, and then I went over and I pressed it so that it would be laying flat. I was afraid if I didn't do that, then when I went to sew it, I might, sew it wrong. So anyway, our last thing is to sew this and then turn it with the right side out, and then you'll see the pillowcase. Now, if you look over here at the machine, you're gonna see this blue tape. What I did was I changed the seam allowance. Usually I sew with a 1/4 inch foot and I can gauge it by this little nodule in here, but I can't do that with this. So what I'm going to do, I did, is I put this tape in here, and the reason that I do that is because I want to make sure that I get in far enough that those raw edges don't stick out. And sometimes they still do, and you have to go back and trim them a little bit. But if you change the seam allowance just a tad, you'll be able to overcome that. So here we go. And I know that when I get to this section here, this is where like all of those pieces met, and we've got the accent pieces in there too. So it might take a little tug to help the machine through. All right. So I am going to backstitch this because I definitely don't want it to start unraveling, especially when I'm sleeping. All right, so here we go. I'm going to backstitch. All right, here. I'm going to follow along on that blue tape. And here I come to that big clump. So I'm giving it a little tug and hoping it going to get through there. Okay, all right, here we go. Thank you. see if I can just turn it. No, I need to go a couple more stitches. I'm going to back stitch it again because, like I said, I do not want this to start to unravel. All right, so we have that. And what do I do with my scissors? Oh well, I'll do this. Okay. Now you can see that we've gone all the way around. Not all the way, we didn't do this side, we didn't have to, but we did that. And so now what I'm going to do is to turn it right side out. I cannot cut this corner this time. So there will be a little bit of bulk in there, but as you can see, this is the seam now, and there's no raw edges, and that's what we call a French seam. And that's so you don't have all that mess on the inside of it. So I'm going to turn it like this. And grab a hold of it. Give it a shake. I'm going to take my purple thing and do these corners the best that I can. Now this one's not bad because it doesn't have sewing on both sides of it. All right, so we are okay there. I'm gonna come over here, and this one's not quite so easy to do. I'm just gonna pull it in as best I can. All right, and here we have a pillowcase. Now I will take it over and I will press these seams because you can see they kind of roll over. They're not laying flat and I don't like that. But here you are. Here is your pillowcase. And what I really, really like about this project is that you can change off during the seasons. You know, like you can do stuff for fall or for Christmas or even just for winter and make these. You know, you could do, if you have someone going off to college, you can do it in the college colors, you know, stuff like that. And if they're into special sports, like, you know, like swimming or soccer or football or whatever they're interested in, dance, there's, you know, some cute fabric to do that. So whatever your family is interested in, you can make a pillowcase to go with that. So it was just a fun project. And it took a little bit longer, you know, today for me to do it to show you. But once you get the hang of it and you, you know, make a few hundred of these, then it will probably take you about half an hour. So you will be able to find these, the pattern for this at the library or online, or you can stop in the store and pick one up. And I hope you like the project. I really enjoyed doing it. Have a wonderful day. See you next time.